patterns we've seen. Zakhapov, Donovan, Shnigor, Rujbani and Mirosatiev are the five. And if it goes to the sudden death, it will be Alan Bekov in the bantamweights. Butsenko, Kilitsin, Mitrofanov is the middleweight that Richie's already pointed out. But I think it is fair to say that a lot of the big names from both the Ukrainian and the Astana teams were used yesterday. It looks to be a lot closer and a lot of less experienced WS boxers in the deep end tonight.
Yep, indeed. It's going to be a difficult night for both camps, I think. There's nothing in it at 3-2. One contest, it can change, can't it? Do you think they can pull it back to 3-3? But I think the Ukrainians tonight will go for Vodzik and Mitrofanov. I think they will be their strong contenders to actually win the contests. And if they can get the first one under their belt and leave the other two to win theirs, then obviously they square it, don't they? It's all level, and then it'll go down to that box off. So yeah, it's very, very close tonight, Nick. This could go either way.
A little entertainment, Kazakhstan style, before the fight gets underway. International, welcoming all of the boxing fans to the Sarayarka Velodrome here in Astana. This beautiful sporting stadium, originally built for the 2011 Asian Games.
Shaka Fasa
Taos International. One of Kazakhstan's top cabaret performers. Now, a little more music before the boxing begins. And Uli Tao will be the next performer.
Thank you. Казахстанская этногруппа Улутау.
Well, Улутау certainly stirring the emotions of the boxers as they prepare for the second part of this WSB final here in Astana, capital of Kazakhstan. We're just a few moments away now from the first of the five weight division bouts. We'll start with the bantams, light, middle, light heavy and heavyweights. This is a professional, the only professional boxing league, team boxing league. 3 minute rounds, five of them. And if today is anything like yesterday's competition, it promises to be a thrilling finale in this WSB final for 2013. The champions in the first year of this Pro Boxing League's inception were Paris, beating the Astana Arlans in the final there. Last year, the title went to the Italia Thunder, and this year we have the Ukrainian Otamans and the Astana Arlans in the final once again, and the Arlans have the advantage. A 3-2 lead after yesterday's competition. Well, joining myself, Nick Fellows, in the commentary box is former super middleweight world champion Richie Woodall himself, with a 29-fight record, including 26 wins, 16 knockouts, and only three losses. Richie, you've said yourself you've been impressed with the WSB as it develops and unfolds as a concept, as a professional boxing team competition. And this is the highlight of what, for many, has been a very long season. 72 matches, 365 bouts, barter days.
Yeah, I've been very impressed with the tournament. On the whole, I think that professional boxing is a sports entertainment industry at the end of the day, and people like to be entertained, and that's what we're getting with these matches. They're very close, they're very even, and there's nothing worse than watching boxing. You know who's going to win. It might be a 70-30 to one boxer. You come in here and you see a 50-50 contest, so that's entertainment for you. And for over 5 3-minute rounds, I've been very impressed with both camps. The quality, the intensity, the fitness of boxers. I think this WSB will go on from strength to strength, and I see a real big future, because at the end of the day, these lads are being paid well, and they're traveling the world, and they're enjoying it, and that's what it's all about at the end of the day. But people are coming out in their thousands to watch it, and I think it's been very successful, and long may that continue.
Now, the two teams that have made the finals, the Astana Arlans, have literally dominated from the start of the season, have been consistent on top of their game since week one, right the way through to the finals. Slightly different story for the Ukrainian Otamans. They started off very slowly, very weak, and then as the tour and the competition unfolded, they started to bring in their big names, their big hitters, their Olympic champions, and came very good at the end. What I'm trying to say, Richie, does that give the Ukrainian team a slight advantage here of possibly having fresher boxers? A lot of their guys haven't had that many fights in comparison to the Astana Arlan fighters, who some have had seven fights coming into this final tonight.
Yeah, maybe so, Nick, but at the end of the day, they have a tough job today, because home advantage for the Arlans. They're 3-2 down, and in each time that they've boxed the Arlans, they've boxed them three times, haven't they? Before yesterday, they'd also fought them twice before that, and they'd lost each time at home and away. So they know they're a difficult outfit to beat, but they have got a large contingent of crowd here. For the Ukraine Otamans, they're well supported, they're well followed, and they'll need that support here tonight, because at the end of the day, when contests are close and the crowd are cheering for one boxer, you know, who knows, it may influence the judges, it shouldn't, but you know, we've seen in professional boxing before, so it'll be important that we've just seen them now, the Ukraine crowd, it'll be very important that they are very loud and support their boxers.
Well, I remember when the Ottomans came to the York Hall, Richie, you and I were in the commentary box there as well, and what a noise that they made, and of course they got the better of the British Lionhearts. First boxer after what's got to be one of the longest walk-ins I've ever seen is Mykola Butsenko. Now, let's not forget that they're trailing by one here. They're 3-2 down, the Ukrainians. Michael Gallagher, the referee, and Butsenko, just 21 years of age, two wins from two fights for this youngster, and very important that Butsenko gets this first win first 3 points on the board if the Ukrainians are going to stay in this, Richie.
Yeah, a bit of pressure on his young shoulders, but he's 2-0 in this tournament. He's boxed very well. Here's his opponent here. And you have a WSB ranking for Butsenko of 6, and his opponent, Miraz Zakipov, he's got a ranking of 7. So again, it's a 50-50 contest, nothing in it at all. And it really is anyone. So both boxers in with a great chance. But Butsenko must, for his camp, get that win and then level it up. So, you know, it's very exciting, Nick. And the crowd know that also.
Well, Zakipov, the Astana Arlans Kazakh boxer, 23 years of age, 3-1, 3 wins, 1 defeat. He's the taller of the two boxers. But looking deeper into the record, Richie, he lost his last fight just before the playoffs, Zakipov, and I'm not sure whether that's just given his confidence a little bit of a boost. He'll need a lot of work, a lot of concentration, a lot of pushing from the coaching staff to try and put that defeat behind him.
Yeah, and when you look at both boxers, their height and their reach, you know, Butsenko is 2 or 3 inches shorter than Zakipov, and that'll be very important, won't it? Zakipov's got to box at range, he's got to keep it long. Butsenko has got to get inside the long reach of Zakipov. So the tactics really are already ironed out, aren't they, between two boxers. Zakipov tall, rangy, Butsenko shorter, got to box more mid to short range and got to push the contest. So styles make fights, and these two styles are going to clash, and it should be an exciting contest with Butsenko on that front foot.
You're absolutely right, Richie, as you said earlier. World ranked 7 and 6, the two boxers in the ring. This is the first of the 5 bouts, bantamweight division. Very evenly matched, I have to say. They've never met before. But of course, the Ukrainians cannot help. But remember, they've lost twice to the Astana Arlans at home and away. Early on in the season, they slowly but surely, as the competition unfolded, changed their tactic, changed their squad, and then for the past 8 to 10 weeks of this competition have been unbeatable. But Zakipov, just ever so slightly the more experienced of the two. But as you said earlier, Richie, this is what makes the WSB so special. Evenly matched, this is anyone's for the taking, this opening bout.
Yep, and it will be very important. And the opening round will be important also to get the nose in front. So, yeah, it's all to play for. Really looking forward to this one.
Well, you can hear the cheers from the crowd. Every seat in the house has been sold for this finale tonight. First of the 5 3-minute rounds. The Ukrainian Otamans out of the blue corner and boxing in the blue and yellow shorts. The Astana Arlans in their familiar gold and black. Nice long straight punches, taking advantage, just as you'd said, Richie. Keeping him as far away as he can, but using that extra reach to put in a couple of early scores here. Good start for Zakipov.
Yeah, he's nice and busy, isn't he? And if you've got those physical advantages, you must use them, and that's why he's mainly boxing. Look at range, straight shots rather than bent arm punches. And Butsenko, although he's the southpaw, he'll have to move those feet into range and get closer up to his man. So yeah, this should be an exciting one.
Good right hand from Zakipov, but very fast fists from the Ukrainian Butsenko. Some excellent body shots as well in those two exchanges.
Yeah, that was impressive there from Butsenko, because he's actually boxing. When he decides to move those feet into range, he's doubling up and he's throwing combinations, working downstairs. But as you will notice, they're bent arm shots. He's got to get up close, and that will be his problem.
Another good right hand, and again from Zakipov. Good 3-point combinations from the Kazakh boxer in the gold. And again, starting to frustrate Butsenko there.
Yeah, what Zakipov has got to do here also Good left to the body from Butsenko. But what Zakhapov's got to do here, Nick, he's target the right hand, especially when Butsenko starts moving into range. He must just throw that right hand with precision, with accuracy, and bring him onto that shot. Because remember, Butsenko's the southpaw. When he closes the gap down, comes forward, he walks onto that right hand, and that's what Zakhapov has got to target.
That's better work from Butsenko. 20 seconds, 25 seconds on the clock here. Another good shot though in return. Retaliation from Zakhapov.
Yeah, this has been a close first round. I think these single right hands from Zakhapov may have just edged it for him. He just looks that little bit sharper, but there's not a lot in it.
You're absolutely right, Richie. I think the southpaw walking on to the right hand of Zakhapov just one too many times, and the judges will have noted that. For me, the Arlans boxer has the round. We'll wait and see.
Yeah, some good stuff here. Good right hands from Zakhapov, bringing Butsenko onto that shot. But Butsenko played his part also. Combinations downstairs. He's willing to trade, but he's got to get up close and keeps walking onto those right hands from Zakhapov. Good round.
And there is the confirmation, all three judges in agreement that Miras Zakhapov, the bantamweight from the Astana Arlans, takes the first round up against Mykola Butsenko for the Ukrainian Ottomans.
Second out. Round two.
Well, as you can see, the southpaw in the blue shorts jabs with the right, looking to get that left hand in. But because of that different stance and style, really needs to watch that he doesn't walk onto that right hand, which it caught him really quite nastily on a couple of occasions in the opener. Let's see if he can just show some slightly better footwork, some better angles to try and avoid that right hand of Zakhapov.
Yeah, and what Butsenko has got to target also, Nick, here is when Zakhapov throws the right hand, sometimes he misses the target and he's overreached and he's overcommitted. That's when Butsenko has got to go back with three or four punches. But Zakhapov boxed him very cleverly on that back foot. Won't commit.
Perhaps a little more work downstairs for Butsenko to start the combinations. That's why he was successful in the first. Doesn't, as yet, seem to be repeating that. There's that right hand on target again for Zakhapov.
See, Butsenko's getting a little bit frustrated now, Nick. What he wants to happen here, he wants Zakhapov to come for him. But Zakhapov very cleverly just staying on the outside. He's not taking the bait. He's waiting for Butsenko. And Butsenko is struggling a little bit here because he wants his opponent to come forward. There you go. As soon as he comes forward, he comes back with the counter. That was good from Butsenko.
Just seeing there, Richie, there's looked to be a cut to the eye, but he's okay. It's just a bit of bruising. To Butsenko, that is. Oh, there again. Counterpunch timing absolutely brilliant from Zakhapov.
You can see how well evenly matched these two are. There's nothing in it at all. It's literally who makes the mistake gets punished by their opponent. Very good indeed. Both technically very good. Oh, that body shot, you know, is a cracking punch from Butsenko. Whips the left uppercut through the middle to the body. This is a closer round.
And I'd like to see more of that one. Start the combination with those body shots, possibly. Certainly an air of confidence about Butsenko's work now, much more than the first.
Yeah, I think this has been a better round. He's beat Zakhapov to the punch. I think Zakhapov now and again has missed the target and Butsenko's punished him.
Good finish for Butsenko in the blue corner for the Ukrainian Ottomans. Is that enough to tie it up? I'm not sure. It'll be very close to second round.
Yeah, close second round. I actually think Butsenko has just done enough. But those body shots for me, I hope they've been scoring them. He's been whipping them downstairs, that left uppercut. And it's like a bolo shot going downstairs. But here, Butsenko on the front foot seems to be scoring a lot more. Let's have a look at the scores.
Absolutely right, Richie. That's why you're the expert in the commentary box. All judges have that Mikhaila Butsenko ahead in the second round. They're all square. Remember, it is five rounds in the World Series of Boxing, the only global pro boxing league competition. Franchises from four continents: Africa, America, Asia, and Europe. And it's Europe and Asia with the Ukrainian Ottomans up against the Astana Arlans of Kazakhstan. They're all square, as expected, an explosive and even match to start tonight's competition. There's the right hand from Zakhapov that caused Butsenko all the trouble in the first, and he's started the third brilliantly here, the Kazakh boxer. He's looking for that right again. Over the top it goes.
Yeah, needed a good start from the round, didn't he? And he got it. A lapse in concentration there from Butsenko. Just took his eye off the ball a little bit there and got caught with that right hand. But again, there's nothing in it, Nick, but a definite better start from the round for Zakhapov.
This is how he boxed the first round, Zakhapov. At range. Almost frustrating Butsenko. And as he comes in to try and make the attack, the counter punch with the right hand really has been explosive. Just a slip. Head a little low.
I think Zakhapov also, Nick, sorry to interrupt, but I think Zakhapov also is just starting to work on the inside a little bit better now. So he's adapted, he's adjusted his style, he's starting to box a lot more now on the inside. Let's have a look at what the referee's doing here.
There's a problem with the lace and the boots, Richie.
He's a good referee, though. Very good referee.
Yeah, Michael Gallagher. He's certainly in absolute control of this set. Opening bat. Oh, there's a good shot this time from Butsenko, just when he needed it. But the return and the counter-punching from Zakhapov in the gold shorts is impressive. This is where Butsenko wants him, in the corner, in close.
I think he's also boxing to instruction here, Zakhapov. He's keeps staying at range at all costs, isn't he? He's got to stay at range, the right target, the right hand especially, but it's all long arm stuff. On the inside, he's starting to work a little bit more now, but he prefers to box at range. That's sensible.
Under a minute to go in this third round. Zakhapov in the gold took the first. Butsenko came back in the blue shorts and took the second. Oh, a good combination. Three-punch combination from Zakhapov.
Yeah, he's turned back to this counter-punching style on the back foot now, Nick, and that's why he's having more success. Butsenko's feet are a little bit slower as he's coming forward, so he's walking onto the shots, and that's what's happening. Zakhapov can see those attacks coming now. He adjusts his feet, brings him onto punches. It's a better display from Zakhapov this round.
Almost taunting Butsenko now, Zakhapov. And as he moves forward, that right counterpunch, which has been so effective from the start of this opening bout, hits the target. Let's take another look at some of the replays here, Richie.
Yeah, the crowd absolutely loved it here. What a sweet right hand that was from Zakhapov. Bang on the target, makes his opponent miss there. Then he switches downstairs. Like we said, he started to work more on the inside, but Butsenko keeps coming forward. His feet are getting slower, walking onto shots.
I've got that third round for Zakhapov. Let's see if the judges agree. Zakhapov, Miras Zakhapov, goes 2-1 up. Now we start to look at the power, the strength reserve, how much is in the tank for these two boxers. They've been going at a frenetic pace for the first three, Richie.
Yep.
Can they keep this pace up for four and five?
Well, it may have an impact on the result the next two rounds because the fitness, rather, of these boxers. But I just think that sense that Butsenko's getting a little bit more tired than what Zakopov is.
Round four. Penultimate round. Now, Zakopov for the Astana Arlans in the golden black shorts has the advantage. Two rounds to one. As you say, Richie, boxing off that back foot. Nice and solid, keeping the Ukrainian at range. Butsenko trying his best with that southpaw stance to get inside.
Yeah, Zakopov holding the centre of the ring very well, won't commit himself. I think there might be a cut. Right eye of Zakopov, there is a little nick there. He's wiping the blood away.
Michael Gallagher, the referee there from Ireland, taking a second look at that cut of the Kazakh boxer.
Now things may change now, Nick. This may bring Butsenko, it might give him confidence. Yet the referee wants the doctor to have a look at that cut.
Oh, we saw one or two badly cut boxes in it yesterday's first part of this final, but there were no stoppages due to cuts in all five of the bouts, and I'll be surprised if we have to stop this one.
Well, you know, this isn't amateur boxing, this is professional boxing, and in amateur boxing a lot of bouts are stopped on cuts, but in professional boxing then they have a good look at it, and again the referee, and he's saying, yeah, that's okay, and that's good to see.
Now, can Butsenko capitalise here, or can Zakopov raise his game as Butsenko now starts to really turn it on, sensing that this is his chance to take this round and put it all down to the fifth and final.
Yeah, that's the red rag to the bull, isn't it? Now Butsenko coming forward, encouraged from what he sees in front of him, his opponent's cut, and he wants to try and make that worse. So he's on that front foot and looking for those shots.
Well, the blood on the face of Butsenko is that of Zakopov's, not his own. 1:30 left in this fourth round. Butsenko knows he must win this round if he's to take the bantamweight division here tonight.
Now, this is a big test for Zakopov physically to keep his man at bay. How strong is he? How accurate is he with the shots? He's getting a little bit more tired now himself, holding on the inside, but he's got to keep his man at distance.
Slight tendency for Zakopov to drop his guard in between exchanges. He needs to be careful there and not forget that he's got quite a badly cut right eye.
Sometimes, Nick, that can be part of the game plan, though, to drop your guard, to draw your opponent in, to bring him onto the shot. But I do think, I agree with you, I think he might be getting a little bit more tired here, more blood coming down. Now and again, the heads are clashing. He's got to watch what he's doing here, Zakopov. And again, a close round. Who's your money on? I think Butsenko has got back into it here.
Oh, and there's a lovely good shot there. A good strong left hand from Butsenko, just when he needed it, 5 seconds off the bell. That could have been enough to make it 2-2, or will Zakopov take that round 3-1 and really put the pressure on Butsenko? For me, just Butsenko.
Yeah, I would have to agree with you. I thought Butsenko there, there was more urgency in his work, on the front foot, working well downstairs, gets caught there with a shot, but backing his opponent up, and the referee had to stop it there to have a look at the cuts, but Zakopov had his moments also. Good counter-punching, in and out stuff. Just gets caught there with his hands low, like you suggested.
Oh, it's not enough. That Zakopov has taken it 2-1, judge. 10-9, 9-10, 10-9. It's a 10-point must-score system. And that means the pressure now is really on Butsenko. He'll need to stop Zakopov to take this bantamweight division back. The first of five weight divisions to be contested here. We knew it would be close, but now Butsenko really does need to find some big punches to try and stop Zakharov in this fifth and final round.
Yeah, a little bit disappointed there for Butsenko. I thought he might have just done enough. Not going to argue too much though, because there wasn't a lot in the round, but I just thought with the doctor having a look in his eye and the blood there and him coming forward a little bit more, there's more urgency for Butsenko. I thought he just might have done enough, but there you go.
Oh, Butsenko's getting through here. He knows he needs to find his biggest punches of the bout so far.
Oh, that's a lovely timed right hand there from Zakharov. Excellent stuff, hitting the target, because if he gets that wrong, if he misses the target, he's overcommitted and then he'll get caught himself. Skillful boxing there from Zakharov.
Check from Butsenko. Kazakh crowd on their feet. That was not a blow from Zakharov to put the Ukrainian on the canvas. Looking a little tired, both boxers now. Blooded face of Zakharov. Just now needs to possibly stick to that tactic. Yeah, but saw him dominate the first, finishing off the same way in the fifth.
And the problem that Butsenko's got now, he keeps walking onto that right hand. He's got to move more to his right, away from that right hand. He keeps moving to his left. And that's why he's walked onto too many. Again, it's been a good boxing display, a clever display from Zakharov here.
Doesn't look like there's a lot left in the tank for Butsenko. For me, he's looking a little tired now. Still wants to move forward, but doesn't have the speed of punches that saw the Ukrainian take the second round.
Just as you say, that whips that left uppercut, or bolo shot, as we call it, into the body of Zakharov. Great punch. What he needs to do after that is maybe throw the right hook, double up a little bit with it. But it's a super shot, that one, and it does weaken your opponent if you hit the target, especially the solar plexus.
Credit where it's due for Mykola Butsenko, still coming forwards, still trying his best at the southpaw to get that foot inside. Oh, and there's a good left shot there, but a great counterpunch from Zakharov at the same time. Right to the closing seconds, these boxers giving their all. A brilliant start to tonight's final. The bell goes at the end of the fifth, and it looks like Kazakhstan has opened the lead now to 4-2 against the Ottomans from Ukraine. What a spectacular start to tonight's card. Yep. But it looks like Miras Zakharov has just done enough, Richie.
Yep, tremendous contest there. The last round especially, the both boxers gave it their all, didn't they? And Butsenko coming forward, got caught with the right hand, but he also delivered some lovely left hand himself, and especially whipping the body shots in also. Very, very close round. If I had to go either way, maybe Butsenko again for me just nicked it, but it could have gone either way. Very close. People all around us on their feet. They loved it. Fantastic contest.
...10,000 tickets sold out tonight here at the Sariarka Velodrome in Astana. And this could be the perfect start to the home team.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have decision of judge committee. Judge 1, 49-46. Judge 2, 48-47. Judge 3, 49-46. The winner is red corner, Miras
Zakharov, after that defeat in week 10, gets back to his winning ways, perhaps in the most important bout of the season, perhaps the most important bout of his professional career to date. Miras Zakharov had to dig deep to deliver the points to the Astana Arlans, but dig deep he did. And what a spectacular start to tonight's competition, and what a great result for Zakipov.
Yeah, tremendous contest. Good display of boxing from him, and he was really tested there and pushed all the way by a real gutsy opponent who gave it his all, Butsenko. And probably on reflection, the judges have just got it right. I actually thought Butsenko very unlucky in a couple of those rounds, but nevertheless, not a lot in the contest at all, but a good display from Zakipov. And Astana Arlans now are going to be very difficult to beat, aren't they, over the two legs. Good performance.
Well, there is the president of the Association of International Boxing, Dr. Chinkwo Wu, will be making the awards. The crowd absolutely delighted to see Miras Zakupov take the opening bout tonight in the bantamweight division. We move on to the lightweight division, 57 to 61 kilograms. And for Kazakhstan, is an Irish boxer coming up next. Eric Martin Donovan is boxing for the Astana Arlans, and he will go up against Gizlitsin from the Ukraine. And the lightweight competition should be as equally closely matched, equally as exciting as the bantamweights. These two guys, once again, both with a similar record, both with experience. But first of all, let's see what Zakipov has to say about his performance.
Yeah. It was a
good time. I was able to get a trainer.
Мы продолжаем на ринге второй бой, ladies and gentlemen, and now it is a turn of lightweight category boxers. Мы приглашаем на ринг боксера из клуба украинских атаманов. Встречаем Вячеслава Кислицына!
Well, Vyacheslav Kislytsyn goes up against Eric Martin Donovan, the Irish boxer, with the Astana Arlans this season. And of course, this time yesterday, we saw Lomachenko, Richie, in the lightweight division. He was absolutely brilliant, but as the number two lightweight in the Ukrainian team, can we expect the same from Kislytsyn?
Well, there's a lot of pressure on Kislytsyn now, because if he loses this, then Astana Arlans cannot be beat, can they? They'll go 5-2 up if they win this one. So a lot of pressure on his shoulders. He's 27, he is fairly experienced. He's not that highly ranked, should we say, but he's got the height and reach over Eric Donovan, and he's got 4 or 5 inches also. So let's just see how this one goes, but they will know that he has got to win it to have any chance of actually winning the tournament.
Well, that is his first year or first season on the WSB competition program. He's 27 years of age, orthodox boxer. Gizlitsyn, 1-1, lost one. Good to see Eric Martin Donovan, who has also won one and lost one in his season for the Astana Arlans. Most importantly, he won, Richie, his semi-final against Stankovic for the Italia Thunder. That gave him a real confidence boost and the self-belief over the five rounds in this style of boxing. And I think that we'll see Eric Martin Donovan possibly boxing with more confidence than we've ever seen him before.
Yeah, obviously that victory is very important for him, confidence-wise. And he's got the crowd, the home crowd behind him here tonight. So he'll be lifted by that, so he's confident going in. And yeah, I'm looking forward to actually watching boxes. I'm a big fan of Eric Donovan. I think he's a very good boxer indeed, southpaw. And I think he can win this contest, but it won't be easy, Nick. Nothing's easy in WSB, it won't be easy.
Well, it's a similar body makeup as the previous bout in the bantamweight. The taller of the two boxers this time is Kislytsyn, the Ukrainian. Quite a taller, longer reach, longer range boxer than Eric Donovan, who is the southpaw. We'll have to get in close. We'll have to work well with the feet. Gerardo Poggi is our referee. I agree with you, Richie. This will be a very interesting bout indeed. But the pressure is really on the Ukrainian Ottomans. They've got to win this one to stay in the final. If nothing else, if they lose this one, they have to win the next three to go to the tiebreak. So it really is a lot of pressure on Kislytsin to do what Lemachenko did last night.
And what they'll be saying to Kislytsin is win the first round. So we may see the Ukrainian boxer come out and really go for it and set a high pace, because he's got to get that first round under his belt. It's all or nothing now for the Ottomans. So they've got to win this one, and the first round will be very important indeed. So I'm expecting a fast start from Kislytsin.
Experienced boxers, both 27 years of age. And Donovan straight about his business here. Wants to make it quite clear to Kislytsin that he wants to play his part in what is looking very good for the Astana Arlans right now. It's so important to get that first bout of the evening. To either side, it's gone the Astana Arlans way, and now Kislytsin must win this.
And straight away, Donovan getting the crowd on his side, boxing well, good movement there. And it's Donovan that seems to be setting the pace. And the crowd are responding very positive to his performance so far, so it's been a good start for Donovan.
Kislytsin, first time he's clearly hit the target. Well, Kislytsin looked happy to just take his time to measure his opponent, but Donovan was having none of that, wanted to get straight down to business the moment the bell went in this first round.
Yeah, for the first minute and a half, then I think Donovan's movement was definitely giving Kislytsin problems. And he's just starting to settle down now, Kislytsin. But as I say earlier on, it's the movement from Donovan that was causing all the trouble.
Good combination there from Donovan, but a counter punch right on target from Kislytsin.
One of the problems Kislytsin has got here, Nick, he is a tall fighter, but if you look at his stance is too wide, and that causes problems in that right hand has to travel further to the target, especially against the southpaw, because you've got a wide base. But also, a boxer with a wide base struggles to move at speed, and that's why he's having problems adapting to that movement of Donovan, no question.
Serious bruising to the left eye of Donovan. Very close first round. Donovan certainly in the early exchanges the better of the two. Kislytsin in the latter part of the opener towards the end of the 3 minutes looking the stronger.
Yeah, good start from Donovan here, right on the front foot, taking the contest to his opponents. Movement was good, boxing, throwing combinations, and Kizlitsyn really was struggling early on in the round to adapt. Better second half of the round for Kizlitsyn. Let's have a look how it goes. Yep, Kizlitsyn just gets two of the judges' scores there. Not going to argue too much with that. I'd have gone the other way personally. I thought Donovan just did enough.
So Kizlitsyn has the advantage, and he needs to win this. Remember, the Astana Arlans are 4-2 up against the Ukrainian Otamans.
Seconds out.
Now Kizlitsyn, knowing that he's got the first round under his belt, so to speak,
round two.
Will hopefully pick it up where he left off, because he was starting to put together some good punches, and I'm sure the word from the Astana Arlans ring where it is to try and just be a little careful going in too fast, getting caught by that right hand by Dutton, which is what happened to Donovan in the first.
Yep. I think Donovan has got to keep moving and box going at different angles. Kizlitsyn is now just catching him with the right hand, so he's got to move more to his right, Donovan, here, away from that right hand. But Kizlitsyn is definitely getting to grips with this contest now. And what he's doing also, after he's throwing that right hand, Nick, he's throwing the left hook. Great combination against the southpaw. And Donovan's got a few problems here, but he's not out of it by no means.
Of holding referee Podgy.
That's good work from Donovan. He's starting to work well downstairs. He's switching the attack as well. He'll throw three or four shots downstairs, then he'll finish on a left hand to the head, and there's another one there.
Gone halfway in the second round. And this was where Kizlitsyn in the first started turning it around. But Donovan keeps coming forwards. Better combinations now from the Ukrainian in the blue shorts.
Yeah, I mean, Donovan is setting a high pace here, but the one thing against the Ukrainians, you've got to be fit, because you know they're going to be very, very strong. They're in good condition. This is a hell of a pace he's setting here, Donovan, but can he keep it going?
Covering up well, Kizlitsyn. I'm impressed with the way he keeps his guard high.
Is there a slight nick above the eye of Donovan? Right eye, or left eye, should I say. There's a little graze there.
I think the ring did a fantastic job off of the first, because that's where he got the knock.
Yeah, left eye. And right eye, Nick, you know, Donovan. I think he might have a couple of little nicks above his eyes.
Yes, you can see Kizlitsyn taking a good look there. Wonderful hook from Kizlitsyn, right on the belt. Hopefully we'll get a close-up shot of Eric Martin Donovan here from Ireland. But some good shots from both boxers in that second round once again, Richie.
That was a close round. I thought Donovan did some great work on the inside. His combinations were fantastic. But Kizlitsyn, rather, himself landing with the right hand, really going for more powerful shots, more single punches. Interesting to see which way they go, the scores, but very close. Let's have a look. Yep, they've gone for Donovan. I'm not going to argue with that. I think he may have done enough just on the inside with the combinations.
Great work from the Irishman. Boxing for the Astana Arlans to level it all up after two rounds. I think, Richie, one of the most valuable points that you made in that round was, can he keep this pace going?
That is the big question now. How fit is he to keep that going?
It has been a frantic start for the first and second round for the Irish boxer, part of the Kazakhstan or Astana Arlans team. But I'm not sure He can keep that pace going. Good opening start here. Good opening exchanges for Kislytsyn. Left hook working beautifully.
Yeah, you see now, Kislytsyn is starting to get a little bit reckless with that right hand. He's really swinging that shot. Sometimes he misses. He gets caught with the left there from Donovan. This is better work from Donovan because his work is more accurate. Better stuff.
Well, Donovan clearly knows that he could put the Astana Arlans in a very strong position here. And this time, the Irishman's counter-punching is doing more harm than Kislytsyn would like.
And the difference here is Donovan's work is more direct and straight at the target. Kislytsyn, it's a little bit wild, throwing hooks. Some are landing, some are not. It looks a little bit scrappy. But Donovan, better, cleaner work.
Complete change as well now. Kislytsyn now doing the chasing. Donovan now boxing off the back foot, and it's working for him.
Yeah, he's starting to bring Kislytsyn onto the punches. Doesn't need to be doing that, so he's overcommitted there. This is a toe-to-toe war, this fight.
Good hook again from Kislytsyn with the left. Hunting him down, Kislytsyn, but Donovan still has his timing. Good body shot though. Oh, he felt that one.
Yeah, some good work to the body from Kislytsyn. Keeps coming forward. He's very scrappy, isn't he? The Ukraine, very, very fit indeed. So impressed with all the Otamans, their fitness. Very good indeed. But Donovan, he's holding it together. Tough, tough fight.
10 seconds left on the clock in this third round. Each of these boxers have taken a round each. This is the turning point with only five, remember, to be contested. Another tough one to mark.
Yeah. You don't get them tougher than that, Nick. That was a really high intensity, high work rate from both boxers. Some great stuff from Donovan, but also Kislytsyn had his sails coming forward, especially with the right hand, but good 1-2 there from Donovan, bringing his opponent onto the shots. His work rate was phenomenal. Could have gone either way again, close one.
Oh, Kislytsyn takes that one, he goes ahead. So, 2-1, Donovan must win this round. The fourth to stay in the match. Kislytsyn can keep the hopes of the Ottomans alive and bring the score back to 3 to the Ottomans and 4 for Kazakhstan if the gentleman on the left of your screen, Kislytsyn, can continue this work rate.
Round 4.
Ottomans out of the blue corner, the Astana Arlans out of the red. Gold and black for Kazakhstan, blue and yellow for the Ukraine. Clearly, the judges were impressed with the way that Kislytsyn approached the third round, coming forwards, trying to hunt down Donovan. And it's exactly the same start in the fourth round as it was in the third.
Yeah, some clever stuff from Donovan on the back foot there, bringing his opponent onto the shot. What he should target is definitely his left hand, but he's got to try and trigger and draw the right hand of Kislytsyn. Make him miss the target, then come back maybe to the body with the uppercut, left uppercut, or bring him onto that left hand. But he's got to draw the right from Kislytsyn and make him miss the target because he overcommits far too much, the Ukraine.
excessive with the shoulder. Kislitsyn. Good work again from Donovan.
Yeah, better work from Donovan. Finding that second win there. He's obviously very fit. He's been up on his toes. He's getting to grips with it again now, the pace. He's adjusting. And that's what boxers do, Nick. They go through periods in a round where they'll go tired, but then the fitness kicks in again. And that's what's happened here with Donovan. He's got a spring in his step and he's willing to work again.
I think both these boxers are running on adrenaline here right now. Such a crucial part of the competition for Kislitsyn.
Yeah, that was
the Ottomans.
That was a big right hand there, Nick, from Kislitsyn. Great shot, well timed. Very dangerous man indeed, and extremely fit.
Looking a little tired in these closing seconds to the fourth round. Kislitsyn has put in some brutal body work in the last 20 seconds.
Again, though, this is a close, close round. I think Donovan done his fair share here. Kislitsyn coming on strong at the end of the round, but Donovan, for me, had a great minute and a half to 2 minutes. Close one. Nothing in it at all. On the front foot there, Kislitsyn with that right hand. But Donovan battled away, he rallied. Got a second win from somewhere, walks onto a shot there, a little bit sloppy coming forward with low hands. But his combinations were a little bit better. Let's have a look at the judges.
Oh, and that's it. Kislitsyn now in a commanding lead. Three rounds to one for Donovan going into the fifth. Donovan needs to try and stop this fight now. That's the only chance for the Irish boxer who's part of the Astana Arlans team.
Judges second obviously out. Favouring that front foot boxing from Kislitsyn. I'm not going to argue too much with that. He's been very strong. He has looked impressive. But I have liked Donovan's work also.
Round five, Besson Sherrod.
Donovan, the referee clearly indicating that was not a knockdown. Work rate seems to have dissipated somewhat from Donovan at the start of this fifth.
See again, Kislitsyn keeps coming forward, but he's walking onto shots. Donovan's on the back foot, but he's bringing his opponent onto those punches. And on punches landed, you know, again, I think Donovan's doing well here.
Fantastic work from the Arlans corner to keep that cut closed up. If you consider that it was opened up in the first round. Over 12 minutes of absolute onslaught, and he looks absolutely fine. Doesn't seem to be affecting his visibility at all. Trying to stay on his toes here, Donovan.
Oh, that was a great shot there from Donovan again, that left hand. Kislitsyn very, very strong indeed on the front foot. Not bothered about his defence too much, coming forward. Good right hand from Kislitsyn. That was a good shot. He's very square, winging them hooks in now.
I thought Donovan may go down with that right hand, Richie. Very strong indeed. And as you quite rightly pointed out, Kislitsyn looks to be holding his form that much better towards the end of this fifth round.
Yeah, again, strength. Sheer strength on that front foot. But makes a lot of mistakes, but he gets away with it. His sheer persistence and his strength just takes him through in his fitness. That's naughty, referee. Don't need any of that.
He's angered Donovan. Oh, a good shot. And it's a count. And surely that seals it now for Kislitsyn.
Yeah, that was disappointing, wasn't it? Because he just seemed to be rallying there. He just walked onto a shot. A little bit clumsy as he's going forward there, Donovan. But nevertheless, a terrific contest. And again, two very fit men indeed.
Right on the bell. Kislitsyn puts Donovan onto the canvas. During the 10-second count, the bell goes to end the fifth and final round. Ukraine had to win this one. And it looks like Vyacheslav Kislitsyn has delivered just in the nick of time.
Yeah, good performance from him on the front foot from the word go. That was that jab that just caught Donovan at the end of the contest there. But Donovan rallied, he came back well. Got a little bit scrappy in there in that last round, but you cannot deny Kislitsyn, I suppose, the victory. There's that right hand there, and he gets the count.
Дамы и господа, есть решение судьи. Ladies and gentlemen, we have decision of judge committee. Judge one, 47-47. Judge two, 45-49. Judge three, 46-49. The winner is blue collar, Vyacheslav Kislitsyn.
Split decision. One of the judges feeling that the Astana Arlans boxer, Eric Martin Donovan, done enough, but it's a win for Kislitsyn. It's now Astana Arlans 4, the Ukrainian Otamans 3. They're back in the contest, Richie.
Yeah, they certainly are. And again, another terrific contest. Both lads giving absolutely everything. This fella is so fit, this Kislitsyn. And I think overall he just deserved to win it. But Donovan certainly had his moments, and it was a close, close bout. But a terrific performance from both of them.
Still with the middleweights, light heavies and heavyweights to go. Absolute delight, and understandably so, from the Ukrainian fans. And you tipped it right at the beginning of the evening, Richie. We may go all the way to the tiebreaker, and it's looking more and more likely still. With the advantage, the Astana Arlans, as we move on to the middleweight contest. And I have to say, once again, this one promises to be a cracker. This time yesterday, Deravyanchenko dominated for the Kazakhstan or the Astana Arlans. But tonight, well, it's Konstantin Shnigur who boxes for the Arlans up against Dmitro Mitrofanov, who's world ranked number 3 coming into this bout, Richie.
Yeah, this is another cracking contest on paper, and I've been waiting to see this Mitrofanov, because I watched him in London when he beat GB Lionheart's Freddie Evans, and I thought I was very impressed with him there, very strong indeed on the front foot. So this promises to be a very good contest. Shniger himself is strong, comes forward, good record, 6-2 second season in this competition, and has a WSB ranking of 6, so you know he's not out of it. This promises to be another good one. This might be these two boxers, style wise, they don't like to take a backward step, so this is going to be a good one.
Мы поздравляем тебя с победой, Слава. Скажи, за счет чего удалось выиграть бой, и все ли задачи, поставленные тренером, тебе удалось реализовать на ринге?
Да, я делал по возможности все, что мог. То, что говорили тренера, я, в принципе, все старался делать, насколько хватало сил. Соперник попался довольно-таки, не сказать, что хитрый, как мы боксеры говорим. Очень волевой. Ирландцы, они все отличаются силой воли, такие волевые боксеры. Ну, я одержал победу. Большое спасибо болельщикам, которые приехали нас поддержать. Нашей команде большое спасибо. Я слышал каждого голос. Слава, давай вперед. И это меня очень поддерживало и мотивировало. Спасибо всем большое.
Мы поздравляем тебя. Спасибо.
Ну а мы продолжаем, мои друзья. Третий бой. Весовая категория 74 килограмма.
Kilos is the middleweight division of the World Series of Boxing. These are the finals for 2013 at the Sariyarka Velodrome, Astana, capital of Kazakhstan. 4-3, the advantage still with the home team here, the Astana Arlans. But this middleweight bout, well, the Ukrainians are quietly confident that Mitrofanov, just like his teammate Deravyanchenko yesterday, can do the business here. He's 23 years of age, an orthodox boxer with a 7-win-2-loss record. He lost his opening fight of the season, but to, believe it or not, Deravyanchenko. But he boxed the quarters and the semis, Mitrofanov, for the Ukrainians. And boxed brilliantly to earn their spot in these finals. And you mentioned it earlier, the TKO against Freddie Evans. They stopped that bout in the third round. The power of his punches there, I remember that night at the York Hall, Richie, was most impressive.
Yeah, indeed, and the intensity of his work rate, very, very strong on the front foot again. And like I say, he hardly takes a backward step. So I think they will feel that he's favourite going into this contest. If he can put in another performance like he did against Freddie Evans, then who knows. But yeah, this one should be a good contest because Schneeger himself is a strong, come-forward, front-foot boxer.
Now, he's an experienced boxer as well. He's an Israeli by birth, Konstantin Schneeger. He's, of course, the number two to the Arlans with Deravyanchenko, their number one. 6-2, his record. Boxed for Mumbai last season, but this season, 4 wins with just 1 loss. Could experience be the key to this middleweight bout? Konstantin Schneeger at 30 years of age, 7 years the senior to Mitrofanov, Richie. Certainly yeah. He's got a lot of miles under those gloves.
He has indeed. He's a bit older, isn't he? He's more seasoned, and I have been impressed with him also. He's strong, and you know, a lot of young lads coming into this tournament, if they're 18, 19, when they're up against a 30-year-old, a real man, you know, who's seasoned and hardened, you know, it's a tough one to get through. And although Mitrofanov is 23, he's strong, the more seasoned boxer is definitely Schneeger, the more experienced. So this one should be a good contest. But you know what, Nick? This weight division, 68 to 73, Kazakhstan in the last three Olympics at 69, a welterweight. They've had 3 gold medalists, and in London 2012, Serik Sapiev was the best boxer of the tournament. So they've always been very strong around this weight division, Kazakhstan.
Well, very interesting. Now, of course, at the blue corner, the Ottomans, the Ukraine Ottomans. If they take this, they'll tie the scores at 4-4. If Schneeger can take this one, then they will go 5-3 ahead with just 2 bouts to follow this middleweight, which means obviously, Richie, my maths isn't the best in the world, but I think anybody can work that one out. They will force the Ottomans to win the light heavyweight and the heavyweight division to take it to the tie break. So Mitrofanov, just like Kislytsin before him, has to stay on his A game here.
Yep, he does indeed. And again, the first round will be important.
And good luck.
This, I'm really looking forward to this because none of these boxers like to go backwards. Should be a good contest, this one.
Slight height advantage for the blue corner, Mitrofanov. Winner of his last 5 bouts, including a quarterfinal and semi-final. So there is no question this man is at his peak in the blue. And as for Schneeger in the black and gold shorts for the Astana Arlans, he too, 4 wins and only 1 loss this season. As our former super middleweight world champion Richie Woodall, sitting alongside me here in the commentary box, has pointed out, Schneeger for Kazakhstan is a seasoned campaigner. contrast of styles, peppering that jab, you see, from Snigur, trying to find an opening or draw his opponent on. And Mitrofanov happy just to go with that right hand over the top on the counter.
Yeah, Mitrofanov is just having a look here, Nick. Just having a look at his opponent. Snigur working well with his jab. He knows what's coming, you see. So he's just keeping that shot going and trying to keep his man at bay as best he can. But Mitrofanov, I love the way he moves his head. That's great movement. But as this contest will go on, you'll see him punch off that movement also. Makes him very dangerous coming forward, moving that head.
Occasions. Seconds just under left on the clock in this first round.
Yeah, in this last 30 seconds could dictate who wins this round. It's been fairly out. If anything, Snigur has been the busier with that jab, but Mitrofanov, he always looks the more dangerous puncher.
And again, lovely footwork, balance and athleticism from Mitrofanov, but he needs to throw more punches if he wants to impress the judges. Well, if the first round is all about getting the measure of your opponent, there's no question that Mitrofanov has done that. But Snigur may have just pinched it for the busier work.
Yeah, I would agree with that. Snigur worked better with his jab. Lovely movement there from Mitrofanov, but he didn't do enough of it for me. Some lovely defensive work from the Ukraine, but maybe he gave his opponent a little bit too much respect in that first round. Let's have a look. And they've gone for Snigur, two judges to the one judge. I'm not going to disagree with that. I think Snigur just did enough to win that round. Bit busier with the jab.
And you can clearly see the coaches in the Ukrainian blue corner. Let's see some more work now. You're moving well.
Seconds out.
Snigur missed so many of his punches due to this fantastic bob and weave movement from the Ukrainian, but now he needs to throw more punches. He's one round down with four to go. Same tactical game plan from Snigur, peppering that jab. But now I'm sure we will see Mitrofanov get a little busier in this second.
Yeah, and a couple of early signs there. Snigur's got to watch what he's doing here, Nick. He's got a very low left hand, and straight away Mitrofanov is targeting that right hand over the top. He's trying to whip, get close to his opponent and whip the shot over. And he'll land that punch as Snigur is actually trying to throw a jab himself. He'll get the timing right. That's what he'll try and do.
We've seen it before on the WSB. It's a big right hand from Mitrofanov. Stopping Britain's Olympic medalist Freddie Evans in the third round.
Yeah, in defence of Evans, I mean, he's only really a 69 kg boxer, moved up to 73, come unstuck against a very good lad indeed. But here now, Mitrofanov just starting to find his range now and putting some shots together, but again, he's got to work hard in it. Good movement with the head, but needs to punch off it. That's better.
Just missed with the uppercut there. Got himself into a superb position.
Look at Mitrofanov here, he's starting to get into his stride, into his rhythm now. And professional boxing is all about more movement from the waist, and that's what this fella does. He avoids shots from the waist, the bobbing, the weaving as he's coming forward. With amateur boxing, it's more movement with the feet because it's only over three threes. But he is a typical, for me, professional style with that movement with the head. That's, look at that, lovely stuff with the movement.
Mitrofanov needs to just keep in the back of his mind is that we're only going for five, not 11 or 12 or 13 rounds here. Because you're absolutely right, Richie. He's got the poise and the work rate as if he was going for a lot, lot longer than those five.
Yeah, quite right. I wouldn't disagree with that. It looks like he's in for a 12-rounder, doesn't it? And he's got to do more work. Schniger again. More work coming from him, volume of punches definitely coming from the home boxer. But the more dangerous man definitely is Mitrofanov.
Very close round. Mitrofanov, for me, better punches. Let's see some of the slow-mo replays. Yeah, Mitrofanov coming forward, good left up there. Just misses with the right hand. Takes him into range again. That wasn't a bad jab. Head down, coming forward, pushing his man back. Schniger just struggling there to keep his man at bay.
All three judges give the second round to Dmitro Mitrofanov, with Konstantin Schniger taking the first, or even once again.
Yeah, even Steven, isn't it now? Mitrofanov there. He's better punches there, winning that round. I thought Schniger did more work, but the quality wasn't quite there.
Round three, Schniger.
Good combination there, straight punch combinations, but effective from Schniger.
Yeah, what is crucial for Schniger here, Nick, is he must keep moving. You cannot afford to hold your feet against this fella. You must hit and you must move, and you've got to be very strong physically and mentally to keep this man at bay. If you break down mentally, then you break down physically, so you've got to have a strong mind. Referee's just sending Mitrofanov the lace has come undone. So Schniger here, Nick, has got to hit and he's got to move. Hold the feet, he brings Mitrofanov into it and he'll have problems.
Oh, there are the combinations, powerful combinations from Mitrofanov.
Yeah, well, it's taken him a couple of rounds to get into this contest, but now he's well and truly into a rhythm. Movement with the head coming forward. He counter-punches on the front foot. That's what he's doing. Coming forward, he moves the head, he makes the opponent miss, and then he'll punish him.
Oh, Schniger. Taking some big punches there.
Schniger here has got to concentrate on straight shots. He cannot afford to let Mitrofanov in on the inside. Mid to short range, this fella is very explosive. He's very powerful. And he's accurate on the inside. You've got to box him at range. Keep your distance, move around him, stay off the ropes and out of the corner.
Under a minute in the third round. First going to Schniger of the Arlans, the second to Mitrofanov, and Mitrofanov looking the stronger for me in this third.
Yeah, most certainly, really going to work now. Snigor has allowed his opponent to get to him far too often in this round. Mitrofanov in that comfort zone when he's in at close quarters. Boxing really well now and into a rhythm.
Rhythm is the word, Richie, almost methodical now. The Ukrainian in blue. He's taken some big shots, credit where it's due. Mitrofanov, the third round on my pad here in the comm box.
Yeah, some good work again from Mitrofanov in this round. Keeps coming forward on the front foot, backing Snigor up against the ropes. Snigor can't keep his distance, can't seem to keep him at bay. And Mitrofanov working well on the inside, head literally on the chest of his opponent, whipping the shots over the top. Yeah, he's strong indeed.
All three judges in agreement. Dmitry Mitrofanov. Fanov is the goes now 2-1 ahead. This is looking good for the Ukraine to get right back into the finals here. This will level the scores at 4 apiece, with just the light heavies and the heavyweights left to box, and a bantamweight tiebreak if we're all square after the heavyweight bout. Still into the fourth round now, and Snigor needs to dig deep to try and save this.
What a super punch that was. That was the best of this round, and probably of the contest. That right uppercut there from Mitrofanov, well timed. You see, what's happened in this contest also, I mean, Snigor has obviously thought about it, because I've watched Snigor box before and he loves coming forward. But he's thought, you know what, I don't want to take this fella on toe-to-toe, I've got to box more at range. And that's quite not his style. You know, he prefers to come forward, so he's trying to box in a style now that doesn't really suit him, and that's why he's starting to get caught. He doesn't know how to keep a man at bay, and this Mitrofanov is very strong, keeps coming forward.
Great work with the left hook from Mitrofanov, especially with this infighting here. Right hand over the top, counter punch works well for... And Mitrofanov really turning it on now.
Yeah, he is indeed, but I think there's a slight tactic change also from Snigor here. He's trying to stay really close to his opponent, probably trying to nullify his opponent's work and then nick the odd shot here on the inside. It's not bad at all from Snigor on the inside. But for me, Mitrofanov, I think we'll feel more at home in at close quarters. Yeah, definite tactic change that is from Snigor. Just holding, trying to stay close. Oh, that's where he doesn't want to be, Snigor. He's allowing Mitrofanov. This is better stuff from the Ukraine. Mid-range work, that's his cup of tea.
Well, Snigor does well to get himself out of the corner there. Oh, and come back with some good work here. Now he's got Mitrofanov on the ropes.
Well, that close, up close, is working, isn't it, now for Snigor? Had a little bit of success there. Turning into a little bit scrappy now, though, and untidy from both boxers.
There goes the bell for the fourth round. Well, a glimpse of hope in the last 20 seconds from Snigor there, but it may have come all too late.
Yep, a glimmer, as you say there, from Snigor, but for me, Mitrofanov still did the better work. He's more comfortable on the inside. He wants that type of contest. Okay, Schneegor got a little bit close at times and didn't allow his man to work, but he found the room, didn't he, Mitrofanov? And that's what he does very well indeed. Just finds the space on the inside to work and land those shots. And for me, yeah, there you go. There's confirmation. He's took every judge's scorecard there.
Great start from Mitrofanov. Now, fifth and final round still to go. And Schneegor provide us with the big upset, the big surprise here. Because mission accomplished in this middleweight bout for the Ukrainian Ottomans. As long as he can just keep it clean. Schneegor trying to lure Mitrofanov into a scrap here and force the errors from the Ukrainian. That's possibly his only chance now.
Yeah, well, his tactic there is to tie his opponent up on the inside and not to allow him the room to actually manoeuvre and work. But Mitrofanov, he's very comfortable in at close quarters, and he's one of those boxers that does find a way. But it's a better response from Schneegor now. He knows he's behind, probably looking for that one shot, see if he can undo his opponent, because at the end of the day, Mitrofanov is there to be hit. He's always there in front of you. But to find that quality shot, that's something else.
Good right hook there from Mitrofanov. Still weaving, moving that head. Again, very closely fought contest this in the middleweight division, as all the bouts being this evening. It's what you'd expect when you reach the finals of a series after 72 matches, 365 bouts. These are the top two pro boxing teams in the world, but there's only one that can take top position. And at the start of this evening's competition, it was all looking good for the Arlans, and the tide is starting to turn and swing the way of the Ukrainian Ottomans.
I'll tell you what, Nick, Schneegor here, he's trying every trick in the book. Up close, tying his man up, sticking his head in his face. This is what professional boxing is all about. He's getting away with it here and there, and he's still in with a shout, and he's battling. He really is giving it a go here, Schneegor.
Absolute commitment from both athletes here. 50 seconds and counting down. Holding on here, Mitrofanov has the advantage. 3-1 coming into this fifth and final round. 3-1 to Schneegor. As you quite rightly say, Richie, the experience. Oh, he's in trouble here. 3-4. Punch combination from Mitrofanov.
Yeah, and Mitrofanov there, Nick, just showing a little bit of quality. That was superb there, because he's been roughed up on the inside, but just found the space again. And Schneegor comes back, cracking end to this contest.
There's the bell. What a great bout. What a war between the middleweights that was. But the Ukraine have kept their hopes alive. And for me, Mitrofanov has done enough to tie the scores at 4 apiece.
Yeah, I agree with you. I think Mitrofanov there has won this contest, but Schneegor has also found a way to try and tie him up on the inside. But there's that little bit of quality in that round that he found Mitrofanov. But they went toe-to-toe, the last 20 seconds or so, very exciting indeed, both going for it. At times it was close, but for me, the inside work from Mitrofanov was superb, and he has won this contest. But all credit to this guy, he gave it a good go.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have decision of judge committee. Judge 1, 46-49. Judge 2, 46-49. Judge 3, 45-50. The winner is blue collar, Dmitry.
The unanimous decision for Dmitry Mitrofanov of the Ukraine Ottomans. And What a great performance, just when it was needed, I have to say. Well, now we start to talk of their tactics, now we start to talk of the role of the coach, now we talk about how important it is to bring the boxers out on the first night or out on the second night. And what an impressive performance there from Mitrofanov to tie the scores at 4-4 with the light heavyweights up next. Ruzbahani up against Gvozdzik, then the heavyweights, and if we're still tied by the end of the heavyweights, we'll go into that bantamweight sudden death tiebreaker, Richie.
Yeah, well, we've said that this is an exciting tournament, Nick, and it really is turning out that way, because now it's even Steven, there's nothing in it at all. This is a big match, this next one, at the 85 kg light heavyweight, and Vodzik against Ruzbahani. This could go in either way as well. For me, Vodzik is the one who's really in form, isn't he? He's unbeaten, he's 8-0. You would fancy him for this one, but Ruzbahani will have the crowd behind him, as a WSB ranking of 3, so again, it's another close one.
Поздравляем тебя с победой. Скажи, пожалуйста, свой комментарий небольшой по поводу прошедшего боя.
Спасибо всем, кто поддерживал меня. Это моих собратьев, товарищей, тренеров, докторов, всей моей команды, которая за меня переживала, держала кулаки. Конечно же, арене спасибо большое за теплый прием и вообще всему Казахстану, что приняли хорошо. Спасибо.
Спасибо тебе за бой.
Браво, друзья, мы продолжаем на ринге четвертый бой. Весовая категория 85 килограммов. Ladies and gentlemen, now we're glad to invite...
So we move on to the light heavyweight division, 85 kilos. Astan Ruzbahani for the Astana Arlans goes up against Alexander Gvozdzik for the Otamans of Ukraine. Gvozdzik will be the first boxer to make the ring. He's 26 years of age, as Richie Woodall, former world champion, has pointed out, just a few moments away, still undefeated in his two-year WSB career. Many of you may remember Gvozdzik from the London Olympics of 2012, where he took the bronze medal, also a quarter finalist at the last world championships in amateur competition in Azerbaijan, in Baku. And but I think most importantly, Richie, is that that unbeaten record means that his confidence just grows and grows and grows. Ruzbahani, possibly the toughest clash he's had all season long, though.
Yeah, I mean, Vodzik on paper may be just favourite going into this one, but he's in against someone who will have the crowd behind him, and he was highly ranked, and he's has got a 4-1 record himself, so he's used to winning. So yeah, this one should be a cracker.
Now, Ruzbahani has been turning one or two heads. He's just 24 years of age. He's Iranian by birth, but boxing for the Astana Arlans. Very impressive debut to the WSB this season. And his confidence also, Richie, at an all-time high. He got a TKO in the first round of the semi-finals up against the Mexican fighter Miskovich.
Yeah, he's also a quarter finalist, isn't he, from the Olympics in 2012 in London and World Championships in 2011. He got to the quarters. So he's a man of experience also. He's confident. He's a southpaw. And he may find Vodzik's style suiting to him. Vodzik has definitely got the height and reach over him. So let's just see how he can, how he gets round that long reach of his opponent. But yet, Ruzbahani is someone who's very, very confident, and I've been impressed with him.
Still everything to play for, to take the world championship for this pro boxing league competition. 4-4 with the light heavyweights on your screens. Heavyweights coming up next. If it's still all square at 5-5, then we'll have a tie break, a sudden death tie break, the bantamweight division. And the bantamweight division, well, we chatted about it earlier, possibly really swings the advantage towards Kazakhstan, who have saved one of their best fighters just in case we found ourselves in this tie-break scenario.
Yeah, when we looked at this, the draw rather, of the boxers, and if it was going to go to a tie-break, it was going to go to the bantamweight division, we knew that the Kazakhstan camp would be more pleased with that, and it may just go down to the wire, Nick, and there's nothing in it, and it's really, really exciting.
Gentlemen, keep your head up, keep your punches up, check out.
As you can see, slight height advantage for Vozdik. Ukrainian opting out of the blue corner, Astana Arlans out of the red. But Ruz Bahani, in his semi-final bout against Mexico, well, he came out like a whirlwind in the first round to stop the fighter from the Mexican Guerreros. And of course, it was the Guerreros who stopped the British Lionhearts in their quest to make the final, taking them out of the competition in the quarterfinals. And you can see him already, Richie. He's looking to do exactly the same here, looking for big punches, fast, hard hitting. No time for measuring. Working out the range here, Ruz Bahani means business the moment the bell goes.
Yeah, we've also seen him box as a southpaw, but he's decided to come out as an orthodox in this contest. Obviously, targeting that right hand over the top of the taller man, so he can chop and change, can't he? He can box orthodox, southpaw. He's comfortable, obviously, as an orthodox boxer. And as I say, he'll be looking to whip that right hand over and get up close. And there's a left hook that wasn't too bad from Ruz Bahani.
Little double jab to move inside the guard there of Vozdik. It's a good start for the Arlans boxer.
Yeah, it is a good start, Nick, and the reason for that is he's not allowing Vozdik to settle at all. You let this Ukraine boxer work behind that jab and hold centre of the ring, then he really does put on a master display. But here, Ruz Bahani really going for it, pushing his opponent back, not letting him settle at all and get into a rhythm. And it's a good start for the home boxer.
Let's not forget he's undefeated in the WSB, Vozdik. Oh, and here we see again Ushan Ruz Bahani, just like he did in his semi-final bout, looking to end it as early as possible.
Yep, and I think he needs to keep this going. Step on the gas. Vozdik is most definitely ruffled here. Can't get into a rhythm, really struggling to contain Ruz Bahani. And Ruz Bahani has got to keep these attacks and sustain this pressure. And for me, he's well won this round. Up to now, anyway.
Big punches again. And the home crowd loving this start from Ruz Bahani. I have to say, so are we. There goes the bell, and Ruz Bahani surely has taken that first round and taken it in style.
Yeah, only one winner there for me, Ruz Bahani, on that front foot. Some good work from him. And he sort of jumped on Vozdik right from the first bell, didn't allow his opponent to get into a rhythm, backed him up onto the ropes. Two-fisted attack, great stuff from Ruz Bahani. Alexander
Gvozdik, Ukrainian. No question. All three of the judges have Ruz Bahani for the Astana Arlans ahead of Alexander Gvozdik. Just wasn't given time to settle, was he? By the
seconds out.
Boxer out of the red corner. This is Gvozdik in blue for the Ukraine. Here's the second round. Now,
You don't need me to tell you that Gvozdzik needs to try and get into this bout, needs to raise his game. And hopefully the corner have come up with a tactical plan to try and keep Ruzbahani at bay.
Yeah, well, the tactical plan here should be ring position. No question, Gvozdzik has got to stay in the centre of the ring. If he allows Ruzbahani to push him back to the ropes, he's tall, doesn't, he's not comfortable there at all. Centre ring, and he can find those long-range shots, then he is in control of things. That's why Ruzbahani had that success in the first round, pushing him back to the ropes and into the corners. Only one winner in that round. You can't allow Gvozdzik to work from the centre and control that space.
Good right hand over the top there from Ruzbahani. But these are much better counter punches from Gvozdzik, who's had a real talking to from the blue corner. But Ruzbahani again, able to dictate the fight the way he wants it.
Yeah, a little bit better here from Gvozdzik, Nick. And that's mainly because he's holding his ground. He's not being allowed, he's not allowing his man, rather, to push him back. So he's having a little bit more success. And this is when he may now start just to get a grip on this contest. And it's really important now for Ruzbahani to keep these attacks going. Ruzbahani boxing at bay there on the outside. He's not doing enough. He's not effective.
From Gvozdzik.
I remember Gvozdzik from the Olympics in London, and I remember him doing nothing really spectacularly, but he does the basics very well. He's a good straight puncher, he's got a good guard, he doesn't make many mistakes. And what Ruzbahani will have to watch out for here is also the right uppercut. He keeps dipping his head in low as he's coming forward. If Gvozdzik finds that shot, that right uppercut, then he may walk onto it.
Once again, Gvozdzik finds himself on the ropes. Very much closer second round. There's a few seconds left on the clock. There goes the bell. But it wouldn't surprise me if the judges went with Ruzbahani for a second round in succession.
Yeah, close second round. A little bit better for Gvozdzik here. Worked very well, but Ruzbahani kept that attack going. There's that right hand over the top, but he also walks onto a left hook and another one, and that made him go back. So a good little sequence from Gvozdzik there, and holding the centre a lot better. A close one, has he done enough to win it? I don't know, let's have a look. Yeah, okay, so they've gone with Gvozdzik. I'm not going to argue with that.
Well, it's all square going into the third round. Oh, the pressure is on here right now. 4-4 at this point in the competition. After eight bouts of 10, possibly 11, as we explained earlier. And it's one round each to Ruzbahani out of the red corner, boxing for the Astana Arlans, and Gvozdzik for the Ukrainian Otamans.
What a left hook that was. Super punch as Ruzbahani was coming forward. Cracking shot that was, Nick.
Well, you talked about it in the second round, Richie. You said that he had to watch out for it. And a dream for Gvozdzik. And now,
oh, the towel's come in. That has surprised me.
And the towel has come in. Gvozdzik's absolutely delighted. What a surprise. We never expected that. And as you can see from yourselves, Ruzbahani absolutely furious as to why the towel has come in from the corner. It means for the first time in the finals of the WSB for 2013, the Ukraine take the lead.
Yeah, I think, you know what? I'd have to agree with Ruz Bahani there. Okay, he got caught with a good shot, and Vodzik was coming forward, throwing a lot, but I was a bit surprised how quickly the towel came in. It was a great left hook from Vodzik that actually put his man on the deck. Let's have a look at it here. Ruz Bahani coming forward, walks onto it. There it was. What a belting punch that was. Bang on the button. Coming forward, here it is. There. Great shot.
Spectacular left hook from Oleksandr Gvozdzik to put the Ottomans into the lead at 5-4. Ruz Bahani still arguing with the coach in the red corner on the left of your screens there. He's furious that the towel got thrown in. I have to admit, I feel for him a little. But that's it. As you quite rightly said, Richie, what a spectacular left hook that was. Came from nowhere. And Ruz Bahani never saw it. Like you say, walked onto it. But it's a TKO in round three for Gvozdzik, taking the Ukraine Ottomans into the lead for the first time in this competition. Now ahead of the home team, the Astana Arlans, by 5-4 as we move on to the heavyweights. Oh, now the Ukrainian heavyweight Arkhipenko goes up against Mirsateyev. And the Kazakhstan heavyweight is the favoured, higher ranked, better record of the two, Richie.
Yeah, this again, on paper, this is another good one, isn't it? But Mirsateyev, he's the most experienced, isn't he? Three seasons now in WSB boxing, so he's very experienced, world series boxing ranking of number four. He's favourite on paper.
Well, you're absolutely right. Four is his number because he's won four bouts, boxed four bouts this season, undefeated in the 2013 season three. He's been with the Arlans throughout his WSB career. Hasn't switched teams. He was a quarterfinalist in the Olympics back in 2008. And as you quite rightly say, Richie, Mirsateyev is the favourite. He's 28 years of age against a 21-year-old Ukrainian, Arkhipenko, who's got a 1-from-3 record, but he won his first bout of his WSB career in the semi-finals to claim his spot in the final team here. And he beat Tony Yoka of the Italia Thunder, who was a part of their 2012 championship team. So, if anything, younger Arkhipenko, possibly least amount of pressure, everything to go for, nothing to lose. But, of course, if Arkhipenko wins, Ukrainian Ottomans will be the champions for 2013. They've got to win this one, the Arlans, to take it to the tiebreaker.
Yeah, and Arkhipenko, you know, he's not the favourite here, but his record doesn't really say the story, does it? Because he's got a WSB record of one win and three losses, but he's lost to... Oh, let's just listen in here.
Ну, я на него надеялся, но, конечно, противник очень серьезный. Первый раунд было тяжело. Не скажу, что ждал, но, по крайней мере, надеялся на такое.
А в какой момент ты понял, что начинаешь выигрывать бой?
Ну, наверное, в первом раунде я еще бой не контролировал. С начала второго раунда уже начал где-то находить какие-то для себя выгодные пути.
Хорошо, спасибо.
Well, Vodzik, I'm sure you've heard the words of Richie Woodall there with regards to just take him down with that left hook because it worked absolutely beautifully. But that was the interview of the winner of the light heavyweight division. We now move on to the heavyweight division. If they tie at the end of this bout, as we've been discussing earlier, Mirsateyev up against Arkhipenko. The Astana Arlans boxer out of the red corner is by far the more fancied favourite and higher ranked with a better record of the two, which would mean if it goes to the form book, we will level the scores at 5-5. If Arkhipenko can cause a surprise and upset here in the 91 kilo plus division, then the Ottomans will take the title. If we go 5-5, then there will be a sudden death tiebreak in the bantamweight division, 50 to 54 kilos.
and we'll have two southpaws going up against each other. But let's wait and see what happens in this next one, the heavyweight division. First man out, 7 years the junior to his opponent. And no question, into the deep end here. But if he can cause the upset, he will be the man that gives the Ottomans the 2013 world title.
Well, he's only won one from four, but it doesn't really tell the story because he's lost to Clemente Russo, a very good Italian in there, and also Filip Hrgović of the Astana Arlans as well. So he's fought good opposition, this fella. Okay, he's been beaten, but, you know, he's mixed it with the best silver medalist in his national champs in 2012. So he's a young man who's learning the trade, and I think he's got a great chance in this contest. But yeah, a lot of pressure on him.
Well, a lot of pressure or an opportunity to become a national hero, one or the two. But Arkhipenko boxing out of the blue corner now. Wait for the roar. Mirsateyev, a very popular boxer in Kazakhstan. 3 seasons with the Astana Arlans, now 28 years of age. An 11-4 record. And of those 11 victories, 6 on points, 4 TKOs to his name, and 1 knockout in his WSB career. He's a big hitter, this lad.
Yeah, and an overwhelming favourite. I mean, 4 victories from 4 WSB contests this season, you know, that takes some beating, doesn't it? Very slight height advantage, but just literally nothing in it there, I would say. But going into it, he's 28, he's seasoned, got the home crowd behind him, yet you would expect him to win this one. And then it's all square again. So, yeah, and the crowd are excited about their man.
So, can the youngster, the underdog in the blue corner, Rostislav Arkhipenko, cause what will be the upset of these finals if he gets the better of Ruslan Mirsateyev, I should say. And Mirsateyev, all of the experience with Mick Bussey, the referee from England. Kazakhstan must win this heavyweight bout to take us to the tiebreaker, sudden death box off, which will be with two bantamweight boxers. Well, of course, this time yesterday evening, it was Alexander Usyk who was the boxer who took top position for the Ottomans, the Olympic gold medalist. But he had to work hard to claim that win. And let's see if young Arkhipenko can do the same and take the world title for the Ottomans.
Round one, Brinsha rounds.
And you can see that Mirsateyev in the gold shorts for the Arlans, looking to put big punches in nice and early. Mick Bussey, the referee, wants Arkhipenko to keep his head up.
And Mirsateyev, one of these boxers on the front foot, prefers to box more mid, short range, looks for powerful shots, mainly bent arm punches. He's got the problem here though against this southpaw. He's got to get in close against him. At the moment he's managing to do that because he's moving his feet into range. But if Arkhipenko just adjusts his feet backwards, then he may have problems to get close to his man. And there you go. Misses with that right hand because he's not close enough.
And
when he misses with that right hand, it leaves a golden opportunity for Arkhipenko to come in with a hook and do some serious damage. Keeping his calm in the early exchanges, the youngster from the Ottomans.
Yeah, very strong on the inside. Mir Sateyev keeps coming forward. There's not a lot of straight punches from him. So he has to get into range to throw those bent arm shots. Oh, heads there. Mick Bassi, yeah, he saw it. That was naughty.
There's a good close here now. Arkhipenko. Just over 30 seconds left on the clock.
He's boxing a clever fight here, Arkhipenko. If he jabs and steps back and brings his opponent onto that left hand, then it could be a long night for Mir Sateyev. He needs Arkhipenko to come forward to walk onto those bent arm shots. He's struggling a little bit here, Mir Sateyev. He just can't find his range. And that's because now Arkhipenko, he's starting to just adjust his feet going backwards.
Mir Sateyev, for me, has taken that round. Much more higher work rate coming forwards. Let's take a look again in slow motion.
Yeah, a little bit better work from Mir Sateyev. But just struggling slightly to find that distance. There's that little headbutt. That's deliberate. I'll tell you what, he's looking to get away with that. In that he didn't get a warning. Let's have a look at the scores.
Yeah. The home man's got it. Mir Sateyev takes the first round, but I'm sure after some words of encouragement from the coaching staff in the blue corner, Arkhipenko may have a few more answers than perhaps we first thought to Ruslan Mir Sateyev. And Mir Sateyev almost getting a little frustrated
seconds
at the
out
end of that first round when he's not allowed to get in close.
Yeah, well, it's horses for courses at the end of the day. But Arkhipenko is boxing a sensible contest.
Round
but it's not pretty to watch.
Ruslan Mir Sateyev.
Yeah, Arkhipenko there was just guilty of waiting too long. And Mir Sateyev landed that right hand, needs to double it up now with the left hook, got to get closer. He's got to target maybe a double attack, never mind a single. Arkhipenko, he's dealing with a single attack, needs to double that attack up and maybe push his man back to the ropes. That's where he's got to target.
Trying to time his punches, isn't he, Arkhipenko? He's trying to wait for the moment.
Yeah, he's just landed a decent left hand there. Good straight shot from Arkhipenko. And Mir Sateyev, now, the problem he's got here, Nick, his head movement is far too slow. So he's got slow feet and slow head movement, and that's making it slightly easier now for Arkhipenko to land his shots. He's got to quicken either the feet up or the head movement and make it more difficult target to hit.
30 seconds left to go in this second round. Boxer in the gold shorts has won the first. This is a much better round for Arkhipenko, but is it enough to tie it up as we're in the closing stages of the second? 5 3-minute rounds. Satayev certainly slowing down. Looking like he's starting to tire.
Yeah, this is sensible boxing from Arkhipenko, and he's timing that left hand well in this round. For me, he's nicked it.
Дамы и господа, в красном углу ринга отдыхает боксер Астана Арланс Руслан Мирсатаев.
Мирсатаев.
Поистине любимый народом Арлан. Руслан на протяжении всех трех сезонов
является надежным тылом казахстанского клуба. Много раз принося победы в решающих встречах в этом сезоне. Наш боксер провел 4 встречи и выиграл 4 из них. So that's a second round to Мирсатаев.
Лучший боксер WSB Азии.
I think the home boxer just slightly fortunate there. He was coming forward, but he got caught with a few of those straight left hands from his opponent, Arkhipenko. And he, as you've said, Nicky, he is slowing down now, this fella. He's got off his game again.
Round three.
Arkhipenko must win this round. Or Mirsatayev will tie the scores to 5-5, and we will go in to the tie break and sudden death match to decide this world championship. A bit more work now from Arkhipenko to secure this third round.
I think at some stage Arkhipenko has been an orthodox boxer. When he throws his left, occasionally his left leg comes forward and he becomes square on. And that's the sign that when he returns to that natural instinct, he wants to turn around probably to an orthodox stance. When he throws his left, his position of his feet aren't quite right for my liking. And that's the sign that he may have been an orthodox boxer in the past.
Well, the work rate now seems to have slowed from Arkhipenko. And Mirsatayev in the gold shorts, that's a better shot, is now starting to sense that he can take this third round as well. And put himself in a very, very strong position. And also the Astana Arlans stay into the competition.
Well, this is a real learning contest for Arkhipenko, but he's not doing enough work. I thought he may have been slightly unlucky in the last round, but in this round here, Mirsatayev coming forward, forcing the contest. There's not enough coming back from the Ukrainian boxer. He's got to do better.
Himself, Major Bell to get out of the corner there. But you could see Mirsatayev coming in to try and finish it in the third. Closing stages now. That's a better shot. Caught him with the hook before and a good right hand. There goes the bell for the third round. One or two good shots in the closing seconds, but Mirsatayev once again, I believe, will have the judge's vote, having done most of the work.
Yeah, the home boxer did the better work in that round, no question. Coming forward, Arkhipenko occasionally landed with some shots, but it was scrappy. Both boxers are slowing down a little bit. But Mirsatayev He's forcing the contest all the time. And for me, maybe just did the better work in that round. Let's have a look.
There you go. Wow. All three judges give that round to Arkhipenko. Well, now we do have a chance of an upset here. So two rounds have gone to Mirziteyev. Arkhipenko takes the third. If he can take the fourth, and we really do have a fight on our hands here, because right now Arkhipenko, who's clearly absolutely delighted, it's given him a boost of confidence, a boost of energy, seeing that he's taken that third round, knows that if he takes the fourth, he'll be boxing not only for the win in the fifth, but also the world championship title.
Oh, again, clash of heads. I think, yeah, the referee's not going to stand for this. That's twice. Look, he's giving him a point warning there. Taking a point off, rather. Use of the head, deliberate headbutting. I think that's just sheer frustration from Mirziteyev. Just can't get to his man. Arkhipenko boxing on the back foot, maintaining that gap. Won't engage and come forward. And the signs are there of the frustration.
Halfway through, Richie, and... yeah, as you quite rightly say, Mirziteyev starting to get more and more frustrated with this approach, trying everything that he can to try and tempt in the young Ukrainian boxer.
Well, I just didn't think that Arkhipenko was being positive enough in that last round, but obviously the judges have seen something that we haven't. And, you know, the old saying, method in the madness, is starting to score with more shots now. He's being patient, and he's bringing his opponent onto the punches.
Well, the Ukrainians are starting to sense that Arkhipenko has got a chance of taking this fourth round here, levelling it all up.
Well, I think he most certainly will with that point deduction as well, Nick, remember. Be very difficult now for Mirziteyev to actually win this round. And again, he's taking punches, coming forward. He's getting slower and slower, and that's making it easier for Arkhipenko.
Keeping his form, Arkhipenko. Keeping at it.
He's obviously boxing to tactics, holding his ground, bringing him onto shots and keeping his shape. Great left hand as well at the end of the round here for Arkhipenko.
And right on the bell almost. And another good round for Arkhipenko. Mirziteyev becoming more and more frustrated with his opponent. Let's take a look at the replays once again.
Yeah, let's have, there's the head look, there's the deliberate headbutt from Mirziteyev. But at times it was six of one, half a dozen of the other. Heads are clashing. This was right towards the end of the round.
And that goes to Arkhipenko. And they are all level going into the fifth round. Well, there's that warning point that we mentioned. Now, it really does become absolutely crucial for this man on your screens to keep the homeboys in the competition. This fifth and final round in the heavyweight decision could well be the decider for the Ottomans. If Arkhipenko can win this round, win this bout, then the Ottomans will be the 2013 World Championships. And for Ruslan Mirziteyev, he's fighting to keep the Arlans in the competition.
Yeah, incredible stuff. And look at the urgency now from Mirziteyev. They know that he's got to win this last round. He knows it.
And he's just going all out now, just trying to drag his opponent into a toe-to-toe battle. Will Arkhipenko, can he keep him at bay? Or is he? Or will he decide to trade with him?
The Ottomans are 5-4 up against the Arlans. They're all square in the fourth round in the heavyweight. If Arkhipenko in the blue shorts for the Ukraine wins this, they will be crowned the 2013 WSB World Champions. Mirsateyev must level the scores and take it to the tiebreaker.
It's scrappy, the odd shots getting home for Mirsateyev, but the cleaner work again is coming from Arkhipenko, the younger man, holding his boxing together, better straighter punches. Oh, Mirsateyev has really got to go for it here, and he's getting more and more tired, Nick.
Well, the Kazakh boxers undefeated this season. Arkhipenko, the real underdog coming into this heavyweight competition. But he's turning the match, and he's again putting in still good punches, holding his form, holding his skills. And what could quite possibly be the upset of the competition will also bring the Ottomans the World Championship title. Referee wants both boxers to keep their heads up. Oh, a wild right hand over the top from Mirsateyev, almost in desperation.
And the more he comes forward, Mirsateyev, the more he keeps walking onto shots. He's absolutely desperate in there. They're both really, really tired now. This last 50, 40 or 50 seconds could be it.
Arkhipenko could become the hero of the Ottomans here. This looked a given for the Arlans on paper. But Arkhipenko has clawed his way back into this. Gets caught square on the feet. Oh, there's a lovely shot from Arkhipenko.
Yeah, great shot, great straight left hand. Mirsateyev just keeps coming forward, walking onto the shots. It's very, very close.
10 seconds on the clock. Can Arkhipenko win the world title for the Ottomans? Still pushing and punching both boxers. No fuel left in the tank. Energy has gone. The bell has gone. And has Arkhipenko done enough to win the WSB 2013 World Championship for the Ottomans? Or do we go to the tiebreaker if Mirsateyev has won it for the Arlans?
Yeah, nothing in it, a really close round again. Mirsateyev coming forward, swinging away, but he's missing the target. If anything, it was Arkhipenko that was catching him with those left hands coming forward. And the crowd think that Mirsateyev has done enough. Literally nothing in it. This could go either way.
The atmosphere out there is electric. Mirsateyev and Arkhipenko, who could have quite easily given us the upset, not only of these finals, but possibly the whole season.
And Arkhipenko, he stuck to his game plan, didn't he? You know, the jab, the straight left hand, it's very close, here it comes.
If Mirsateyev in the black and gold for the Astana Arlans wins this, they will tie at 5-5 and we will go to a sudden death box off with two bantamweight fighters. If Arkhipenko is given the bout, the Ottomans will take the 2013 championship. Here we go.
Yes, решение судей. Ladies and gentlemen, we have decision of judge committee. Judge one. 46-48. Judge 2, 48-46.
It's one each, this is the decision.
Judge 3, 47-47. Winner is Rutkova Ruslan!
Oh, well, the red corner takes it, it's a 2-1.
Oh, incredible stuff.
And judge 3, 47-47, but it's gone to the home boxer.
We go to the tie break. Mirsateyev only just ties the scores at 5-5. What a brave performance, a sensational performance from Arkhipenko. But not quite enough to take the world title back to the Ukraine. So we go to the tiebreaker. There will be one more fight, sudden death. And Alim Bekov for the Astana Arlans will go up against Rishkan for the Ottomans. Bantamweight division, 50 to 54 kilos. Two southpaws battling for the world championship title for their teams.
Yeah, on paper, you'd have to go for Alim Bekov of Astana Arlans, to be quite honest. But this is the final, and Rishkan will put everything into it. So this one again, Nick, I'm looking forward to it. But I think the home boxers, the home team, slightly fortunate to be going into this box-off, personally.
Well, I thought Arkhipenko may have just done enough. But Mirsateyev, with his win in the heavyweight division, ties the scores at 5-5. The tiebreaker will be the decider. There's the confirmation. Zakhapov, first win for the Arlans, then Kislytsyn, Mitrofanov and Gvozdzik, three in a row. Then we've just seen the heavyweight decision. That was so close. Split decision, but just given to Mirsateyev to tie the scores at
5-5.
So, Alim Bekov, the higher-ranked boxer of the two, goes against Arushkan, 23-year-old Moldovan, and it's the Ottoman boxer that will come into the ring first.
Earl Simmons, a.k.a. the dog, fly down for real and going hard.
Well, the Ukrainian supporters must have almost had their hands on the world championship trophy there, but we've got to go to one more bout, the tiebreaker. Alexander Rishkan, Moldovan by birth, 3 wins to 7 losses, and only 1 win this season puts him in at 29 rank. Again, the Ukrainian clearly the underdog of the two in this tiebreaker.
Дамы и господа, встречаем Александр Рышкан.
Huge amount of pressure on this young lad's shoulders, just 23 years of age.
Алында шаршаланга, арланымызды қарсалыңыздар, Бағдат Алимбеков!
And a huge cheer from the crowd for Bagdad Alimbekov. Much better record, unbeaten this season. 5-1 record, 24 years of age, his second season with the Astana Arlans, and he boxed in the quarterfinals and the semi-finals to earn his place in the squad and earn a place in the finals for the Astana Arlans. And I think this is a very clever tactical play by the managerial and coaching staff of the Astana Arlans, saving one of their best for the tiebreaker. And on paper, by far the higher quality boxer than his opponent, Alexander Rishkan. You wouldn't want to bet Alim Bekov. Things are looking good for the host nation, Richie.
Yeah, it's a clever move, isn't it? They knew that it was going to be close. It's come to the box off. We have two southpaws, though. And this is the perfect stage to make yourself a superstar. And Alexander Rishkan can do that against the home favourite in Alim Bekov. So you never know in boxing, Nick.
Well, we certainly saw that, didn't we, in the heavyweight contest with Arkhipenko.
We thought that he would have no chance up against Mirsateyev, and almost snatched the title for the Ottomans. And once again, the Astana Arlans boxer is the favourite. That's Michael Gallagher, our referee for this tiebreaker. An extra fight or bout, and whoever wins this will take the World Championship title for 2013. Tense moments. Tense moments for these two boxers who've been waiting and watching very, very closely, because if Akipenko had won that heavyweight division, these lads wouldn't have needed to have boxed.
Yeah, very true. And just looking at it on paper, you have a WSB ranking for Alan Bekov of number 3. And his opponent, Riskamp, 29. So on paper, he is an overwhelming favourite, Alan Bekov.
Watch your heads, keep your punches up, shake hands, good luck.
Out of the red corner, the Astana Arlans.
Round one,
Alan Bekov. Out of the blue corner, in the blue and yellow striped shorts, is Alexander Rishkan. World rank 3 against world rank 29. The man in the gold shorts is the man to watch. Very fast hands from both boxers in the opening exchanges.
Yeah, early on here, Alan Bekov, very relaxed, low guard. What he's actually trying to do, he's trying to draw his opponent in. But he's in against a man who's got fast hands also. And sometimes he's being caught in his own trap there, Alan Bekov, because he's being caught by Rishkan coming forward with those fast hands. But that's what he basically wants Rishkan to do, is to come forward. And that's why he's got that low guard to draw him in.
Riskan lets Alan Bekov know he's not going to get it all his own way. Good combinations from the boxer in blue. Good counter-punching as well.
Yeah, and the shot Riskan is going to have to watch out for here is this left hand over the top. Look how low his hands are. He wants him to come forward, but when Riskan comes forward, Alan Bekov will look for that punch there, that left hand over the top, and he'll target that shot as Riskan's coming forward. There it is there, little shot there.
His tactical plan is clear, isn't it, from Alan Bekov. Incredibly fast, not only with the punches, but also with his feet.
Yeah, he's just starting to get into his rhythm now, Alan Bekov. Fast, sharp punches. Rishkan finding it difficult now to actually land punches coming forward because of those fast counters.
Дамы и господа, в синем углу ринга отдыхает легионер украинского клуба Александр Рыжка.
Yeah, good work here from Alan Bekov, in and out, hands low, very relaxed, very sharp indeed. Obviously very confident. Rishkant at the start of the round had some good success, but as the round went on then, I thought Alan Bekov started to get into his stride a little bit. Confidence coming through. For me, he won it.
Alan Bekov takes the first round unanimous with all three judges. And the Astana Arlans take their first step to the 2013 World Championship title.
Seconds out.
Any tips for Ruskan, Richie, to try and keep Alan Bekov at bay?
I think he's got to punch more when Alan Bekov actually comes to him. I don't think he needs to be looking for him on the front foot because he'll walk onto that left hand. You've got to remember, Alan Bekov is very, very fast with that shot over the top. And Rishkan's feet aren't too quick, so he must punch as his opponent comes towards him. You see, that's no good. The way he started off there, he just walked onto shots. This is where he's got to work more.
Rishkan mustn't let himself get caught in the corner here. Needs to make a nice turn, pivot out. Michael Gallagher, the referee, instructing Alan Bekov to keep the head up.
And what Rishkan has got to do here, Nick Moore, is try and trigger his opponent off, then act as the counter-puncher on the back foot. That's when he'll catch his opponent coming forward, but it's not working. He's not doing it. Difficult, he's in against a very fast man.
And Alan Bekov clearly with his execution, he knows exactly what he wants to do, where he wants to be. Again, the head up.
Oh, good stuff.
Great shot there from Alan Bekov.
His punches are a little bit quicker, aren't they? He's faster to the shot, Alan Bekov. Fast hands. Oh, lovely punch.
The right hand's doing a lot of damage at the moment. Minute to go in the second round. Let's not forget that Alan Bekov, in the gold shorts, has already won the first and has got control of the second here.
See, that's better, come back with that left hand. That's mainly because Alan Bekov made the mistake of overreaching and then he caught him with the counter there, the Rishkan, so that wasn't too bad, and that's the type of contest he must target. But he's just not quite quick enough with his reactions at this stage and with his punching speed. Yeah, I think this has been a clever move by the Kazakhstan team here, Nick, to hold one of their best boxers, hold him back for this weight division.
Second round surely has gone to Alan Bekov. Credit where it's due. Rishkan is having a much better time of it than perhaps many would have thought.
Some good stuff here, though, from Alan Bekov, working well to the body. Look at that double right hook to the body, then a little left. There's that 1-2, that was a super punch. That's the punch that we spoke about, that left hand over the top earlier. Good round for the home man.
No questions. Alan Bekov now just needs to take this next round. And one of the biggest upset that we've possibly seen in this competition. He will take the tiebreaker and the Astana Arlans will be on their way to a World Championship celebration.
Seconds out. Round three, Ushich round.
Well, this pro boxing team competition is all about the strength and depth of your squad. 12 teams, 257 boxers, 39 countries, 10 Olympic medalists. But it's been the tactical play, just a little bit of a tangling of the legs there. It's been the tactical play
of the Astana Arlans that looks to be bringing them this pro team title.
Yeah, there was a tangling of the legs, but also he got caught with a right hook at the start of the round, did Alan Beckhoff. And that, if anything, has triggered him off here, really ignited him into throwing big, heavy shots. And he's really going for a stoppage here now, Alan Beckhoff. That left hand over the top is so dangerous. Whips it, there it is again, look. Oh, and then he switches to the body, good work.
He's got a right hook in his repertoire as well. Real dynamic fighting. Good work from both. Alan Beckhoff is clearly hitting that target. The target being Alexander Ryshkin. Far more often than the Ukrainian in blue.
Well, Alan Beckhoff now, he's really showing us his skills, full repertoire of skills that he has, boxing well as a counterpunch on the back foot, but he can also fight going forward, prepared to take a shot to land one also. He's there to be hit, and that's what makes him so exciting. The crowd love it.
Good counter punches though, this time from Ryshkin. Gets himself out of that corner with some good shots.
Oh, there's that left. Oh, superb. How he just slips to the right with his head and then whips that right, that left hand over the top. Technique, fantastic.
And Ryshkin has no answer to it either, Richie.
No, I mean, the kid's really up against it here. He's in against a man who's got power, speed, skill. And, you know, he's boxing on home soil. It doesn't get much tougher, to be quite honest, for Ryshkin.
There goes the bell for the third round, surely. The third round has gone to Baghdad Alimbekov with these kind of shots. And that means, bar a knockout or a TKO, Alim Beckhoff has not only won this tiebreaker, but he's also won the WSB Team Championship title for 2013 for the Astana Arlans. Comfortably ahead now, Alim Beckhoff. Ryshkin will need a knockout. He'll need to stop the fight. Just can't see that happening, Richie.
No, the signs aren't good for Ryshkin. Look at Alan Beckhoff, he's off his stool. You watch Ryshkin, he's still on his stool and he'll literally sit there and get every second of rest. So the signs aren't good for him.
Well, Alan Beckhoff now wants to put on a show for the crowd here. There it is again. Like you said earlier, Richie, he's prepared to take one, to give one.
Yeah, he is an exciting boxer. He stands there. He's got a good guard on the inside when he wants it. He'll tuck his elbows in, but he's very relaxed. And he drops his arms, literally to get the relaxation in, the speed in his punches, but also to draw the lead of his opponent, and then he reacts to that. Clever boxer.
Halfway through the fourth round, and Ryshkin really has no answer to this onslaught from Alim Beckhoff in the black and gold shorts. He stood his ground. He's shown that he can take a punch or two. There's no question. The Ukrainian Ottoman fighter. But Alim Bekov, world class here today.
Yeah, and as the contest has gone on, one of the problems that Riskan has got, he doesn't really possess any real power that is troubling his opponent. Alim Bekov, they're bouncing off him literally, and so there's no respect there from Alim Bekov. He feels he can walk through Riskan, and Riskan's decent, but he hasn't really got the power to trouble his man, his opponent. Sneaky little shot there on the inside from Alim Bekov. Good reply though, good response from Riskan. Big shots though here from the Kazakh boxer.
There goes the bell for the fourth round, and great respect for each other. Excellent sportsmanship between the two boxers, but Alim Bekov remains in control of this tie-break competition. Easily taking the fourth round of my card here in the commentary position with one round to go. And the host nation, the Astana Arlans, will take the WSB Championship title. They were in the final in 2011 against Paris, where they were defeated there, but they've waited patiently, built their squad, worked incredibly hard, and they have done enough. Surely now, Alim Bekov just needs to go through the motions in this fifth round to take the title to the Astana Arlans.
Yeah, it'll be interesting last round. He will want to finish it very strongly, I would have thought. So it'll be interesting to see.
Seconds out. Round five. Pearson shootout.
Fifth and final round. Alim Bekov in the gold and black shorts for the Astana Arlans has comfortably won all four. I'm sure he'll want to win the fifth and put on a show for the crowd and his fans.
Occasionally he'll make a mistake there, Alim Bekov. The way he's coming forward, his legs crossed and he went to the orthodox position. But he doesn't make many mistakes, this fella. And he rectifies them very quickly with those fast hands. He gets himself out of trouble. And I think he's just enjoying it now, and he's enjoying the atmosphere. Knows he's winning this, but will want to sparkle most certainly in this last round.
Gone halfway. Alexander Riskan has demonstrated, like all of the Ukrainian boxers here at these finals, they are a real tough bunch to deal with. He'll not give up. He keeps plugging away. He knows he's up against far more skillful, far more successful opponent, but he's kept about his business. There's that shot again, that lightning left hand.
Yeah, very, very sharp indeed. Very sharp jab also from Alim Bekov. And the difference here has been the speed of punch. I mean, it's incredible. Alim Bekov's speed, very, very quick. And it's making Riskan look fairly slow, but I'm sure he isn't. I'm sure he can hold his own with almost anyone in this division. And he's got fast hands, but against this guy, who is, his pace is electric with that jab and his combinations also.
And as we've said with one or two other boxers this evening, Richie, for me, Alan Bekov looks like he could go another five rounds. He could go 12, no problem at all.
Yeah, looks very fit indeed. And that's been one of the most impressive things about both camps here. Very fit boxers indeed. And they've made that transition from three threes to five threes now as professionals. And it's encouraging to see.
There he goes. The fifth and final round has gone to Alan Bekov. And after 10 bouts of boxing over 2 days, the world title has been decided in the tiebreaker. Brave performance from Alexander Ryshkan. But we always knew it. Richie, we spoke about it before the start of our program today. If it went to the tiebreaker, it would be impossible to stop Alan Bekov.
Yeah, we always knew that he was favourite on paper and put in a great performance, especially in the earlier rounds. Very fast hands, good variation, can box on the back foot, but can also box going forwards. Switches the attack from body to head, fast combinations at the end there with the body. Good, good performance. And a clever move from the Kazakhstan camp.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have decision of judge committee. Judge one, 50-45. Judge two, 49-46. Judge three, 50-45. The winner is Rankona Baghdad.
Baghdad Alan Bekov wins the competition, the whole series for the Astana Arlans, the 2013 champions. The Astana Arlans begin their celebrations. Alan Bekov, the trump card. They saved him till last, just in case they found themselves in the tie-break situation. And it was a tactical play that was to prove the undoing of the Ukrainian Ottomans. Great, great result for the Astana Arlans. It was so close. And the home team begin their celebrations.
Чемпионы третьего сезона всемирной серии бокса становится команда Астана Арланс.
The World Series of Boxing Season 3 for 2013 is just a few moments away from crowning their new champions, the Astana Arlans. Well, perhaps the unluckiest boxer of the night was Arkhipenko in that heavyweight clash. That was almost the breakthrough and the championship title for the Ottomans. Just lost
him. Arkhipenko, he could have got it, couldn't he? So, yeah, very close indeed. But overall, I think the right team has probably won here.
Спускайте. Да, да, yes. Команда Астана Арланс. Буквально на 2 минуты спуститесь, пожалуйста, с ринга. For few minutes, please. Несколько минут, друзья.
Well, celebrations put on hold. A few speeches, a few official presentations to be made. The awards will be made Итак, the president of AIBA, Тачицико Ву.
Разрешите пригласить на ринг серебряных призеров всемирной серии бокса третьего сезона. Встречаем украинские отаманы!
So the Ukrainian team will be asked to go to the ring first. To claim their runner-up title here, the Ukraine Otamans.
Нет ничего радости битвы, назад ни шагу. Любой из них продемонстрирует свою отвагу. Команда украинских атаманов уже здесь, живущая по принципам, расподобность честь. Заложен в генах этот воинский дух, ведь редко бы имена произносить боялись слух. С настроем мощным они приходят в зал.
For me, Richie. Great performances from Usek and Lomachenko. And also possibly the best performance for the Ottomans tonight, Gvozdzik, with that TKO, spectacular punch.
Yeah, they got some special boxers in their squad, no doubt, Lomachenko, Usyk, and Gvozdzik. After a shaky opening round, he came back very well and produced that perfect left hook. So yeah, they have got some very good boxers in their team.
Ladies and gentlemen, for the awarding ceremony, we invite AIBA President, Mr. Dr. Wu. Let's greet, ladies and gentlemen. And for the awarding ceremony, we invite to the ring President of Kazakhstan Boxing Federation, AIBA Vice President, Mr. Timur Kulibayev.
Dr. Wu, the President of AIBA, on the left of your screens, Timur Kulibayev, Vice President, will make the presentations to the runner-up team for the WSB Season 3 2013.
Дамы и господа, ваши бурные аплодисменты. Аплодируем, друзья! Ladies and gentlemen, the first floor is given to Dr. Wu, please.
Dear boxing fans, dear supporters of the boxing, tonight you have seen probably one of the highest quality boxing competition. WSB third season will be concluded, finished tonight. But I want to give my words, greeting words, to both teams. All the boxers, you are winners. You all are winners.
Уважаемые любители бокса, фанаты бокса, сегодня вы видели прекрасное качество бокса. Хочу поздравить обе команды. Вы обе выиграли.
My congratulations.
Мои поздравления.
To Kazakhstan.
Казахстану.
But I also want to send my greeting to Ukraine.
Но я хочу поздравить и Украину.
I hope everybody enjoy.
Я надеюсь, все получили большое удовольствие сегодня.
WSB will continue and looking forward to the next season. But tonight,
WSB продолжится. Я с нетерпением жду следующего сезона.
But tonight, we're going to give the prize and go to the honor to the winner, both of them.
Но сегодня мы будем давать призы и благодарить и чествовать обе команды.
Thank you, спасибо.
Спасибо и всего наилучшего.
Итак, дамы и господа, с серебряными призерами третьего сезона всемирной серии бокса становятся украинские атаманы! Серебряный кубок этой команде!
Well, the Ottomans, who defeated the 2012 champions Italia Thunder to earn their spot at these finals, came so close, didn't they, with Arkhipenko. Rodzik took them ahead with the TKO in the light heavyweight. Then in went Arkhipenko for the heavyweights and was just and only just by the narrowest of margins denied the win. That took the competition to the tiebreak. And in the tiebreak, we all knew that the Arlans had their trump card to play.
Дамы и господа, вот и ответственный момент оглашения победителя не только этих двухсторонних финальных боев, но и всего регулярного сезона всемирной серии бокса. Дамы и господа, встречаем на ринге чемпионов команду Астана Arlans!
And the presentation and award for our 2013 WSB season champions, the Astana Arlans. Alan Bekov doing enough in the tiebreaker to give the Arlans the win. Bulat Mankinov, the general director, competition manager Serik Kasimov, the sports manager Nurgarzi Berbeyev, and of course Korinchki, a famous coach now with the Arlans, delivering yet another major title and championship winning team performance.
Дамы и господа, вас не слышно!
Деревянченко may be the big favorite for the Kazakh fans in the Astana Arlans, but all of their 11 boxers in action over the past 2 days here in Astana have done their team and their individual countries proud.
Третьего сезона становится команда Астана Господа, чемпионский кубок, золотой кубок вручает президент Казахстанской Федерации бокса Тимур Аскарович Кулебаев и доктор Бу. Аплодируем, друзья! И, конечно же, помимо чемпионского кубка, чек на сумму 500 тысяч долларов!
Well, congratulations to all of the boxers who have participated, all 257 of them, in the 2013 WSB Pro Boxing League Season 3. Rest assured they'll be back for season four. The Arlans will be the team to beat as the defending champions. But watch out for the Ukraine and all of the teams that have performed so well in this truly successful and original pro boxing team competition. I hope you've enjoyed all of our coverage from the WSB this season, and in particular our coverage from Astana in Kazakhstan, the host to the finals. From Nick Fellows and former super middleweight world champion Richie Woodall, thank you for your company. It's goodbye for now, and once again, congratulations to the Astana Arlans.